Grandparents are getting off, and here come the grandkids. Hi, Amy. I'm Sarah, Grandpa. Well, he's third-stage Alzheimer's. He's forgetting things that are related to person. Stage four is basically the terminal stage. See, and like I said, Alzheimer's just is a series of forgetting. What happens in stage four is the body forgets how to work. The mechanism in the throat here will forget how to swallow. The gut will actually forget how to break down food and how to absorb it. So they'll start to lose weight because they're not getting nutrition, and they'll go into malnutrition. And what finally happens is the immune system. The immune system forgets how to work. And if you are in a mall in Kansas City, somebody walks next to you that has pneumonia, and they cough on you, and you breathe it in, and you don't get pneumonia, you have your immune system to thank. Because your immune system is your fight, your fighting system, that anything that gets into your body, basically, your immune system is going to go into action and send things to that area. From a cut on your hand, to breathing in pneumonia, to anything, it's going to go to that area and fight to keep you well. Well, in fourth-stage Alzheimer's, the immune system forgets how to work. And what usually happens is the people get pneumonia, and they finally succumb to pneumonia and pass away. So these are basically the four stages of Alzheimer's. When we get in that section, we'll talk more about it. Diagnoses, first impression, functional nursing, holistic, you can kind of read through those. Home health and hospice, we've already talked about. I'm just trying to look at the words that we need. Pet therapy, this is a big thing. The dogs and cats in the nursing home are really a really cool thing. They weren't well accepted when it first started happening, but now it's getting more accepted because, you know, the dogs and cats go around, they jump on the person's bed, and the person gets to pet them, and they get love and give love. And pet therapy has been now proven to basically be a good thing, where the dogs and cats go around and literally do a service for the people, provide a need. And it's pretty neat. Primary nurse and procedure, registered nurse, professionalism. Like I said, I believe certified nurses' aides have to be just as professional as a registered nurse. Because because you are a nurse, you know. When I became an LPN, I had a doctor say to me, "Oh, you're an LPN," you know. In other words, a shrimp, a no good. And I thought, you know, that kind of hurt, you know. And I'm thinking, I thought about it. I said, "No, I'm not. I'm a licensed practical nurse. I go out on the ambulance. I'm working people that have heart attacks, delivered a couple babies, delivered a lot more as an RN, not going to do any more." You hear that, right? Okay. And it's the same thing. I've heard people put down CNAs. And you know, if I hear it, I basically act out, you know, because they, you know, you are professionals. You are a nurse. May have a little bit different title behind your name than my name, but that doesn't matter. You're a caregiver. You are taking care of other people. You are a nurse. You are a professional. Rehabilitation, resident-focused care. Resident-focused care and cultural diversity is something that's basically new coming to basically our field. Okay, this is wonderful. I forgot how to turn it off.